So please, today we'll be starting with the chapter Strategy, Cost Management. Please stop talking, settle down. Quickly settle down, please. In the previous class, see, I just gave an overview of the first unit in the study material called as Developments in Cost Accounting. I also gave the importance. It accounts for around 18 to 20 marks in the examination question paper. It's very, very important chapter and very simple also. We discuss the concepts. The concepts are very simple but novel concepts. Where it may be new to you, once you have learned, it is not at all difficult. It is straightforward and simple issues, not as complex as QT chapters, etc. But very important. The developments in cost accounting comprises of lot of small chapters. Mainly a theory dominated area only. If you look at the study material, most of the theory comes only from that particular slot called as Developments in Cost Accounting. Theory part, I have given you the summarized theory version, more than enough at the end of the workbook in the theory segment. And most of the theory comes only from that particular chapter. But in the class, while discussing the concepts also, I will cover the maximum theory that is possible. I will not cover point by point, but I will try to give you a big idea or picture about what each and every concept is all about. With classroom discussion, we will be having a real knowledge about what those concepts means. And for examination orientation, one can go and refer the back of the workbook where it is a study material theory which has been given. Wherever possible, objective type theory question asked in the examination, we'll discuss in the classroom itself. Again, we will be doing this area elaborately since it is important from the examination viewpoint. And today we'll be covering two concepts. I will cover a concept called as throughput costing. We cover a concept called as throughput costing. And we'll get started with another concept called as theory of constraints. Next class we'll complete the theory of constraints. If we have time, we can start with the just-in-time. Subsequent class we'll do the just-in-time completion and start with the backflush costing and so on. So each class will be doing one or two concepts in this particular chapter, strategic cost management or developments in cost accounting. In this first chapter itself, there are two areas called as target costing and then activity-based costing. Which I will be dealing as a separate chapter. Okay, there is a chapter in the workbook called as target costing and ABC. Because from that area, every time problems are being asked. Mainly ABC problems are regular future, a feature in the examination. And target costing uses ABC for its answers. So it can be ABC alone or ABC with target costing that can be asked in examination. That we'll be doing in the second slot once we complete the transfer pricing. Today's class and one more class, we'll complete this chapter, transfer pricing thoroughly, and then continue in that slot the ABC and then target costing. In the first slot, we'll be doing the small areas like throughput costing, theory of constraints, total quality management, life cycle costing, just in time, backflush costing. These areas will be covering in the first segment or from 4 to 5:30 start will be covering it. And these are all straightforward, simple issues only, nothing complicated there to discuss or understand, but should be having a knowledge to answer the examination problems. Okay, now let us start today with the first concept called as what? Throughput costing. Before that, give the heading, strategy cost management. Give the heading, strategic cost management. Strategic cost management. Bracket right, developments in cost accounting. Strategic cost management. In bracket right, developments in cost accounting. Please. Strategic cost management. Bracket right, developments in cost accounting. learning objectives. Learning objectives. Number one, point number one, throughput costing. Learning objectives, point number one, throughput costing. Point number two, theory of constraints. Point number one, throughput costing. Point number two, theory of constraints. Theory of constraints. Point number three, just-in-time system. Point number three, just-in-time system. In record right, JIT. Just-in-time system, in record right, JIT. This is a well-used abbreviation. Like the theory of constraints also, TOC. Question paper uses TOC in the questions. Abbreviation is well-recognized. Theory of constraints is TOC. Then just-in-time system, JIT. Point number three or four? Point number four. Back flush costing system. BACK, back flush costing system. Back flush costing system. Back flush costing system. BACK, back flush costing system. Point number five. Total quality management. Point number five. Total quality management. Please, total quality management. Bracket drive TQM. Total quality management TQM. Point six, life cycle costing. Point number six, life cycle costing. Point number seven, target costing. Point number seven, target costing. Point number eight, activity-based costing. Point number eight, activity-based costing. Bracket la ABC. Activity-based costing, in bracket right, ABC. Activity-based costing, in bracket right, ABC. The last two will be dealt as a separate chapter. Today we'll be starting with the first concept called as what? The throughput costing. You are getting throughput costing. Okay. Let us have a brief introduction discussed. I'll give you the introduction notes after the problem has been completed. Okay. Now, listen. Earlier we discussed in standard costing and marginal costing. A concept called as marginal costing versus absorption costing. Remember or not?
Yes, sir.
We have two systems, namely marginal costing and absorption costing. One more system is there. It is called as throughput costing system. Okay. Used in factories for decision making purpose. The third system is called as what? Throughput costing system. Let us have an idea about all the three systems and the comparisons. We can do a problem involving all the three systems. Okay, now. First we had cost. The cost we classified into two types. Can tell me all the two types of cost? Manufacturing cost and then what? Non-manufacturing cost. Cost was classified into manufacturing and non-manufacturing. Non-manufacturing costs are administration and then what? Selling expenses. Manufacturing cost we further classified into three. Number three, tell me. Direct material, direct wages and overheads. Overheads are classified into what? Two. Namely what? Variable overheads and then fixed overheads. Respond, yes or no? No. At that time we discussed that costs are of two types. Product costs and then period costs. Product costs are those costs which are considered for stock valuation. Period costs are those costs which are not considered for stock valuation. In case of period costs, the entire cost expires in the same year itself. But for product costs, It expires only to the extent of the cost of goods sold. What is attributable to the stock will go to the next year via stock. Is what we discuss about the product cost. Now tell me, 10,000 rupees product cost will be fully charged against current year revenue? No. Out of the 10,000 rupees product cost, what is attributable to goods sold? We call as cost of goods sold. And what is attributable to the goods not sold? We call as closing stock and take it to the next period. But period cost expires fully. Everybody read or not?
No.
The main difference between marginal costing and absorption costing is regarding the classification of what? Product cost and period cost. Both the system, all non-manufacturing costs are always what cost? Period cost. Whether it is variable or fixed. All the non-manufacturing costs, administration, selling is always period cost. Will never go for stock valuation, is or no? And in marginal costing and absorption costing, material, wages and variable overheads, all the three are always it as what cost? Product cost. The main bone of contention is regarding what? Fixed overheads. Marginal costing says that fixed overhead is what cost? Period cost. Should not go for the stock valuation. Are you able to recollect or not? And absorption costing says that fixed overhead is what cost? Product cost. You should unitize using a predetermined absorption rate or standard rate, charge it to the products, and it becomes a stock valuable cost or inventoryable cost. Everybody respond, remember or not? No. That is, in marginal costing system, I value my stock at variable manufacturing cost. In absorption costing, I value my stock at full manufacturing cost. It includes what? An unitized fixed cost. Enough or not? We also saw the income statement of marginal costing and absorption costing. Just wanted to summarize. What is the absorption costing income statement? Sale minus cost of goods sold gives you gross profit. What is cost of goods sold? Opening stock of finished goods add cost of production minus closing stock of finished goods. Where the opening stock of finished goods and closing stock of finished goods is valued at full manufacturing cost. Cost of production includes what? The absorbed fixed manufacturing cost also, right or not? From the gross profit reduce what? Administration and selling expenses plus or minus over or under absorption. This happens due to use of the standard rate to absorb the fixed overhead. You will be getting the profit. Is or no? When it comes to marginal costing, can tell me the income statement? Sales minus variable cost of goods sold. That gives you what? Gross contribution. What is variable cost of goods sold? Opening finished goods add variable cost of production minus closing finished goods. Where opening finished goods and closing finished goods are valued at variable manufacturing cost. When I reduce some sales variable cost of goods sold, what I get is profit or contribution or contribution. Because I have not reduced a fixed cost. What I get is contribution or gross contribution. Gross contribution because I have not reduced variable selling and administration. Yes or no? Sales minus variable cost of goods sold gives you gross contribution. Minus administration expenses. Minus variable administration and selling expenses. That gives you what? Contribution. Minus fixed manufacturing, administration, selling expense. Are we getting what? Profit. This is regarding the marginal costing system. Respond. Is or no? No. The difference between the two profits. Tell me the difference between the two profits. Is due to under absorption or absorption? No. Both have been adjusted. Why the profit is different? Due to stock only. If there is no stock, both should give you what? Same answer. If there is stock, then the fixed cost inside the net stock will be the reason for what? Difference between the marginal costing and absorption costing profit. Able to recollect? Huh? No, are you able to understand or not? No. So what is the difference between absorption and marginal costing profit? Fixed cost inside the net stock. Is there no? No. When you discuss marginal costing, absorption costing, break-even point, I elaborately discuss the demerits of an absorption costing. That is only the important point from that I am going to take off my discussion. Can I say? No. What is the main disadvantage of absorption costing system? Answer is, it breeds inefficiency. It breeds what? Inefficiency. Suppose my normal capacity is 1 lakh units. How many units? 1 lakh. I budget normally to produce and sell how many units? 1 lakh. This time the demand is very low, then I am able to sell only 30,000. How many units? Yeah? 30,000 units. Now, tell me my profit should be more, it should become a loss. Loss. But what I can do is, even though I have a demand for 30,000 units, I may still produce what? 1 lakh units and build up a stock of 70,000. Right or not? What advantage of building up a stock here? A part of the current year fixed cost goes into what stock, gets postponed to what next year. I can report a profit this year. Everybody is on no. It breeds what? Inefficiency, because fixed overhead is allowed to escape to what? Next year via stock, even though there may not be what? Any demand for the product in the current year, I can still show some profit by boosting up my stock. Everybody is on no. So this is the main demerit of what? Absorption. Due to this, what happens is, if I unnecessarily build a stock without any demand, just to show I'm a good P&L account, after 2 or 3 years, suddenly I may come to know that is a top management, I come to know that the entire stock is what? Unsaleable or what? Obsolete. Okay, then what the company has to do? Write off entire stock in 1 year, where they will be reporting huge losses. By that time, the person who is reason for what? Inefficiency might have escaped. Everybody following what I am saying? So, absorption causing system breeds what? Inefficiency. It may be good for an external reporting purpose, where the tax authorities or the accountants may require you to value stock at what? Full cost basis. But it is not good for a decision making purpose or for a control purpose, because it is going to camouflage the inefficiency and then show what is otherwise a bad P&L account to be good. Everybody following not? These are demerits of what system? An absorption costing system. Respond yes or no? No. Tell me. Why we are against fixed cost going to next year? Sulba. Tell me. Why fixed cost should not go to next year? Just because I produce goods, fixed cost is not incurred. Even if I don't produce, it is going to be incurred. Yes or no? Fixed cost tracing as a product cost, main objection is, even if you don't produce, the fixed cost is going to be what? Incurred. So the fixed cost is not based on my units produced, it is based on what? It based on what? The period. It based on the period, it's going to be incurred. So they said that through stock, don't transfer fixed cost, because when I produce one unit, what I really spend to produce a pen is only the variable cost in that pen. It is not what? The fixed cost inside the pen, because even if I don't produce a pen also, it will be incurred. So if you produce what? 1,000 pens more also, it is going to be incurred. So don't allow the fixed cost to go with the product, because it is not related to the every production. Are you following what I am saying? This is a disadvantage. We said fixed cost should not go into what? Next accounting period. Everybody following or not? No. See. Marginal costing is better, because when I produce a pen, I spend the variable cost. When I don't produce a pen, I don't spend the variable cost. Okay. The metal inside this pen, or the wage spent for the manufacturing of the pen, or even the power and other costs are all spent for each and every unit. So it is logical to trace a variable cost to each unit produced. Is what we said as an advantage of what? Marginal costing system. Right or not? No. Now they say, marginal costing system also is not so good. It is also what? Not so good. Don't value the stock at variable manufacturing cost. Don't value the stock at what cost? Variable manufacturing cost. Value the stock at direct material cost. Everybody saw no. When I value the pen, suppose I have produced a pen, I have not sold it. I have not sold the pen. This is a closing stock or not? I should not value the stock at variable manufacturing cost. I should value the stock only at what? Material cost. Inside the finished goods, how much metal is that? You find out. Yes or no? The metal consumed by the product alone should go for what? Stock valuation. Wages and overhead should not go into what? Stock valuation. Everybody following up? This is what throughput costing is all about. So tell me, absorption costing values my stock at what? Full manufacturing cost, including what? Fixed overheads. We disputed by saying that don't include fixed overheads, because it cannot be taken to what? Next year. Because even if I don't produce, it is going to be what? Incurred. It breeds inefficiency. It is what cost? Period cost. Hence we preferred what system? Marginal cost. Marginal costing says valid what cost here? Variable manufacturing cost. Throughput says that is also wrong, because don't value your work in progress stock or what? Finished goods stock at the manufacturing cost. Valid what cost? Raw material cost. Conversion cost. What cost here? Conversion cost. Heard this name earlier or not? In one of the standard costing chapter, never cover? No. In the conversion cost means what? Wages and overheads. The word conversion cost means cost of converting metal into some other form. Conversion cost, namely wages and what? Overhead, should not go for the stock valuation. The reason is very simple. Okay, now. See, I am consuming some power to manufacture this pin. Variable cost. Yes or no? And workers are paid on piece rate basis. What basis? Piece rate basis. And the wages variable or not?
Yes.
If a manufacturer, wages occurs, don't manufacture, wages does not occur. If I produce, power consume, not produce, power does not get consumed. It's all no. Now, agreed, these are all what cost?
Variable cost.
But I say, don't take it into stock, because when I transfer the pen to next year, power will not be transferred. Put it over. Isn't it correct? Can I transfer worker time? In a power time and all are intangibles. There is not at all one asset. In a closing stock is asset or not? What is the asset? Power. Show the power. Yes or no? What is asset? I say wage asset, wage time, labor time. Time is lost because at that time it has been spent. I cannot get yesterday's 3 o'clock once again today. Right? What I am saying? In that case, see what they say is, what goes through the output is not wages. What goes through output is not what? The overheads. What can go through the output is only what? The raw material. Okay. We understand the significance of this more. We will discuss the theory of constraint later. Everybody following or not? We will be having in the next class a very conclusive discussion where this is going to be play a very, very important role. Are you following or not? Now, what goes through output will not be the variable cost, will not be what? The wage cost. What goes through is only what? Raw material. Is all no? No. Next year, suppose the finished goods become what? Obsolete. Let us take an extreme situation. At least I have a material to sell. I cannot sell a labor time. I cannot sell what? A power consume. I cannot spend what? Sell what? A repairs, depreciation, etc. Those items cannot be sold because they are intangibles. Are you following what I am saying? What is really going from one place to another or one year to another is only what? Raw material through the output. So they say don't value the stock at what? The full manufacturing cost. Don't value at what? Variable manufacturing cost. All the stocks, either it is raw material stock, work in progress stock, finished goods stock, should be valued only at what cost? Raw material cost. When I have finished goods, suppose a finished pen consumes 1 kg of plastic, I will value this at what? Cost of 1 kg of plastic. A WAP consumes 0.5 kg of plastic, I value how much? 0.5 kg plastic cost only. I don't worry about how much wages spend, how much overhead spend, because they are non-inventoryable, or they are what? Period cost. Is what throughput costing system is all about. Everybody understood or not? No. The significance, again I say, of the throughput costing can be understood only when we discuss about what? Theory of constraints. For theory of constraint concept only, this system was what? Developed. It is about operations management or factory management, where it's a very, very useful and helpful concept. Everybody, are you following or not? So now, consolidate. Cost can be of two types. What types of cost? Product cost, period cost. What a product cost? Cost concerned for stock valuation. What is period cost? Cost not concerned for stock valuation. In case of absorption, what is the product cost? Material, wages, variable, fixed overheads. In case of margin, what is the product cost? Material, wages, variable overheads. In case of throughput, what is the product cost? Only material. And all the others are treated as a period cost. They won't go to next year through the inventories. Is the introduction to this concept called as throughput costing system. Everybody respond. Is or no? No. And let us start doing a problem in this regard. One problem in the throughput costing before we have a brief notes. Okay. These chapters will not have too many problems. And whatever that they are included in the workbook, mainly for these chapters, the good book is Hongren. Okay, next week and above. Do these standard problems. All problems are what? Standard, deep, thought provoking. Hongren always uses everything differently. Okay, that is, if you buy a Hongren book, it will be difficult to identify chapter name. Okay, we call a standard costing. The standard costing will be in four chapters spread over. It's all over. ABC will be having a standard costing concept. Like that, overheads will be there in what? 4 or 5 chapters. The book is written very, very differently. And truly, the chapters are similar to what we discussed only. But the problems are what? Very deep. And these chapters, the just-in-time, backflush costing, all these issues, from that book only, generally, institute regularly ask the problems. What were possible that has been covered in the classroom. Concepts are what? Very simple. But we don't have too many problems to solve in these areas. Can I start or not? Now. Take question number 15. I will give you the notes once I complete it. Take question number 15. Page number 212. 212. Question number 15. Question number 15. Page number 212. Please. Stop talking. See. If you look at the previous page, the topic we are covering is absorption costing, marginal costing and throughput costing. This issue we are covering. In which question number 13 has been done or not done? Yeah, Sulupa, 13 has been done or not done? When we did question number 13, anybody? When we did question number 13? I am not asking the month name, which chapter? Standard costing. Before I started discussing about the sales variance, I discussed this problem in what? Standard costing, at that time we completed 13. 14 is a very small sum regarding marginal absorption. And the 15 sum is what? Including the throughput. Can I proceed or not? Now, take question number 15. All of you. Now the time is 4:35. Before 5, we should complete this sum. Can I start or not? Now. Emerson Corporation. Can I start up? No. Emerson Corporation, which uses throughput costing, just completed its first year of operation. Since it is first year of operation, we will not be having what? Opening stock. Am I correct? No. Planned an actual production equal 10,000 units. I budgeted to produce 10,000. I also produce what? 10,000. That means there's going to be no over or under absorption. Can I put it up? Yes or no? No. And provided there is no expenditure variance. Yes or no? Fixed overhead variance is nothing but over under absorption. That happens due to two reasons. Volume and then what? Expenditure. No. I don't want to kindle the old ghost thoughts and all. Can I say 10,000 units? And sales total 9,600 units or $72 per unit. Cost data for year are as follows. Direct material 12, conversion cost. What is conversion cost? Labor and overheads. Direct labor 45,000, variable manufacturing overheads 65,000, fixed manufacturing overheads 2,20,000. See, that in selling and administration cost, variable A, fixed is 1,18,000. The company classified only direct material as throughput cost. The word throughput means what cost goes through output. We call as what? Throughput. Okay, next. Required. Compute the company's total cost for the year, assuming that variable manufacturing costs are driven by number of units produced and variable selling and administration costs are driven by number of units sold. Even if they don't sell, as I tell, we have to understand that. Can I proceed? Next. How much of the cost would be held in the year-end inventory under absorption, variable costing, throughput costing? What the other name for variable costing? Marginal costing. Prepare Emerson's throughput costing, income statement. I'll prepare income statement for all the three systems. Absorption costing, marginal costing, as well as what? Throughput costing. Can I start or not? No. Let us start with the solution. We need not waste time. Let us do it together. Can I proceed up? No. Madam, first. Calculation of total cost. This number I want for some further explanation. Question also asks you, part 1. Compute the company's total cost for the year. So, calculation of total cost. Step 1. Calculation of total cost. Straightforward, simple calculation. Nothing great. Can I start or not? No. First. First cost is what? Have the three columns, particulars, computation, amount. Particulars, computation and then amount. Okay. The first item of cost is direct materials. The first item of cost is direct materials. Okay. Production costs are tied to units produced, units sold, units produced. And I consume material both for produced goods and what? Produce and sold goods and unsold goods also. Can I proceed? No. How many units produced? 10,000. In the how much rupees? 12 rupees. That gives you 1,20,000. 10,000 units into 12 gives you 1,20,000. Direct material. Others are given. Next is what? Direct wages given. Direct wages given. How much is direct wages? 45,000. Variable overheads. Next is variable manufacturing overheads given. How much is given? 65,000. Variable overheads given 65,000. Variable manufacturing overheads given 65,000. fixed manufacturing overheads, FMOH, fixed manufacturing overheads given. How much it is given? 2,20,000. 2,20,000. Just to answer, if I total all these four, I'll be getting what? Manufacturing cost. And what? Administration and selling. And variable selling overheads. Variable selling overheads. The 8 rupees is spent for units produced, units sold, units sold. 8 into how many units sold? 9,600. 9,600 into 8. 9,600 into 8. How much it is? 76,800. 9,600 into 8, 76,800. Fixed selling overheads given. How much is given? 1,18,000. Fixed selling overheads given 1,18,000. Total cost. Total cost. Tell me, what is the total cost? 6,44,800. What's happening? Total cost 6,44,800. 6,44,800. Now, stop and tell me, profit is equal to sales minus total cost. True or false? Profit is equal to sales minus total cost. True or false? Profit is equal to what? Sales minus expired cost. Because entire total cost need not be charged against the current year sales. A part of the total cost goes into the stock and gets transferred to what? Next year as an unexpired cost. So, no. So we have to know that profit is equal to what? Sales minus expired cost. How much of the total cost expires? How much does not what? Expire. Yes or no? All the three systems, expired cost is same or different? Different. Because the way a value stock in absorption costing is full manufacturing cost. Marginal costing is variable manufacturing cost. Throughput costing is what? Material cost. Since the stock value changes, the profit also what changes? The amount inside the stock only becomes unexpired cost. In the return or not? So can I go to the next step or not? Now, they ask you to value the stock under all the three systems. Can I go say, tell me, how many units are having in stock? Because I produced 10,000, sold what? 9,600. I have stock how many units? 400 units. This 400 units should be valued at selling price or cost price? Cost price. What cost? Manufacturing cost or total cost? Manufacturing cost. It is full manufacturing cost for absorption, variable manufacturing cost for marginal, material manufacturing cost for what? Throughput system. Everybody, yes or no? No. Can I proceed further? No. Right now, next step to stock valuation. Step 2, stock valuation. We can do it together because computations are simple. As we compute, we can understand also quite easily. Okay, step 2, stock valuation. Step 2, stock valuation. Everybody, can I start or not? No. Have three columns. Items, absorption costing, marginal costing, throughput costing. Or particulars, absorption costing, marginal costing, throughput costing. Okay, shall we start or not? No. First cost is what? Direct materials. First is materials. Is material considered for absorption costing? Yes. So write it there, 1,20,000. Is material considered for marginal costing? Yes. Why is it there? 1,20,000. Is material cost considered for throughput costing? Yes. Why it is? 1,20,000. This item of manufacturing cost is considered in all the three systems, hence taken into account. Can I understand or not? No. Next item is what? Wages. Okay. 45,000 rupees wages. Is wages considered in stock valuation for absorption costing? Yes. Write it. 45,000. Is wages concerned for stock valuation marginal costing? Yes. Right, 45,000. Is wages concerned in throughput costing? No, leave it. Just leave it. Can I proceed? No. Next is what? Variable overheads. 65. Is variable manufacturing overheads concerned absorption costing? Yes. How much rupees? 65,000. Is variable manufacturing overheads concerned for stock valuation marginal costing? Yes. How much rupees? 65,000. Is variable manufacturing overheads concerned in throughput costing for stock valuation? No. Put it dash. Next item is what? Fixed manufacturing overheads.
Is FMOR's concern in absorption causing stock valuation?
Yes, 2,20,000.
Is FMOR's concern in marginal costing?
No.
Is it concern in throughput costing?
No.
Product cost, that is a cost which are concerned for stock valuation, product cost. What is the product cost in absorption costing? 1,65,000 + 65,000 + 2,20,000 gives how much?
4,50,000.
What is the product cost under marginal costing? 2,30,000. What is the product cost in throughput costing?
1,20,000.
4,50,000, 2,30,000 and then 1,20,000. Respond, yes or no? Product cost spent to produce, or spent to what?
Produce.
They are spent to produce,
how many units?
Production. How many units are spent to produce there?
10,000.
So these product costs are incurred to produce how many units?
10,000 units.
Cost per unit. This is a cost that should be considered for stock evaluation, okay? Cost per unit. What is cost per unit for stock valuation in absorption costing?
45.
Marginal costing values are stock at what cost per unit?
23.
Throughput costing how much per unit?
12.
So the cost per unit under marginal absorption throughput is 23, 45 and 12. Next is what?
Closing stock.
Closing stock. How many units are there in closing stock?
400 units.
How many units are there?
400 units.
How many units are there in marginal say costing?
Same 400 units.
Throughput costing 400 units. Stock units are same, but the value what?
Differs.
So closing stock value. Closing stock value. Each unit valued at 45. What is the stock value in absorption costing?
18,000.
Stock value in marginal costing?
9,200.
Stock value in throughput costing?
4,800.
18,000, 9,200 and 4,800. Everybody, yes or no? To this extent, the cost goes to the next year. Everybody, yes or no? Without calculating, tell me, which will show maximum profit? Absorption, margin or throughput? Which shows highest profit? Absorption, margin, throughput? Absorption. And more cost is transferred to next year. Less cost accounted this year. More profit is reported. Yes or no? Which shows the lowest profit?
Throughput.
Because it does not allow cost to escape in the name of what stock? It logs all the cost in the year of incurring result. Yes or no? So, really if you want to say conservative, which is conservative? Throughput costing only is a conservative system. Everybody, are you following or not?
No.
So this is regarding the stock valuation. Can I go to the next statement?
Now,
look at the question now. We have answered two questions. How many questions? Two questions. Point one. What is required one? Compute company's total cost for the year assuming that variable manufacturing costs are driven by number of units produced and variable selling administration costs are driven by number of units sold. Is the first question answered or not?
Yes.
We found out the total cost to be some number. What number you found out?
6 lakhs and odd.
How much you find out? 6,44,800. Second question. How much of this cost? How much of the 6,44,800? How much of this cost would be held in what? Year-end inventory. How much held in year-end inventory in absorption costing system?
18,000.
How much in marginal costing?
9,200.
How much in throughput costing?
4,800.
Of the total cost, this cost is held in year-end inventory. Taken to what? Next year. The balance cost expires. Respond. Is or no? No. Next is third question. Prepare Emerson's what statement?
Throughput income statement.
I will prepare absorption costing,
marginal costing
and throughput income statement. All the three will prepare. Even the question is not asked, we will reconcile what? All the three and show how the cost behaves. In the back, any procedure?
No.
Right on. Step 2 or step 3? Step 3. Income statement. Step 3. Income statement. Under three systems. Income statement under three systems. Income statement under three systems. Under the three systems. Can I start or not?
Now,
have the following four columns. Items, absorption, marginal, throughput. Items, absorption, marginal and then throughput. Items, absorption, margin and then throughput. Can we start or not?
No.
See, first item income statement is what?
Sales.
First item is sales. How many units sold? 9,600.
At how many dollars? 72. Tell me the sales amount. 691,200. Income will not change. It is going to be the same. 691,200. Sales 691,200. 691,200. 691,200. Okay. Now, don't write. Let me discuss and then we can just write it. Now, from the sales, I reduce cost of goods sold in absorption costing. What is cost of every unit? 45. If I multiply 45 with units sold, I get what? Cost of goods sold. Multiply the problem with what? Units not sold, I get closing stock. Is or no? No. So when I multiply 45 with 9,600 units, I call it as what? Cost of goods sold. Enna paridana? Now, suppose I multiply 23, I multiply by what? 23 with 9,600 units, I call it as what? Variable cost of goods sold. Enna paridana? If I multiply 12 with what? 9,600 units, I call as throughput cost of goods sold. Everybody saw no? Or material cost of goods sold. Both are what? Same. Enna apurujira? No. That means, when I multiply units with the full manufacturing cost, I get what? Cost of goods sold. Units sold into variable manufacturing cost, I get what? Variable cost of goods sold. Units sold into material manufacturing cost, I get what? Material cost of goods sold. Or throughput cost of goods sold. Everybody, are you following or not? Can I pause it? No. Now, let us discuss next. Sales, when I reduce cost of goods sold, what it is what? Gross profit. Sales minus cost of goods sold gives you what? Gross profit. In marginal costing system, sales minus variable cost of goods sold gives you what? Gross contribution. I got that was contribution. Throughput costing, sales minus material cost of goods sold. Sales minus what? Material cost of goods sold. I give a name called as throughput contribution. Called as what? Throughput contribution. One of the objectives of theory of constraint is to improve the throughput contribution. Everybody following that? That is given a specific name called as what? Throughput contribution. Now tell me, sales minus CGS gives you what? Gross profit. Sales minus VCGS gives you what? Gross contribution. Sales minus MCGS. MCGS means what? Material cost of goods sold. Gives you what? Throughput contribution. Everybody saw no? From that reduce what? All the period cost, I'll be getting the profit automatically. In the part, or not? No. So can I proceed further? No. I think you should finish writing the sales. Can I proceed? Next. Minus. Since I am preparing a multi-columnal format, I just write, I have to take appropriately minus CGS or VCGS or TCGS. Solupa, what is CGS? What is VCGS? What is TCGS? Throughput cost of goods sold. Even you all call us what? Material cost of goods sold. Both are what? Same. Okay. Sales less CGS or VCGS or TCGS. Appropriate name should be attributed to the respective columns. Can I put it or not? No. Tell me, cost of goods sold. Calculate it for, take the calculator. 45 into 9,600. I want a number. 432,000. 9,600 into 45, 432,000. Next thing is, 9,600 into 23. 9,600 into 23. What's the number? 220,800. 220,800. 9,600 into 12. What the throughput cost of goods sold? 115,200. Everybody understanding it or not? No. Sales minus cost of goods sold in absorption, they call us what? Gross profit. Sales minus variable cost of goods sold in margin, they call us what? Gross contribution. Sales minus TCGS, they call us what? Throughput contribution. They write the respective names for the respective column, right or not? No. Gives you GP. GP means what? Gross profit. GC means what? Gross contribution. GT means what? Gross throughput contribution. Okay? Now, I hope you can understand the abbreviations clearly. Number is or no? No. Now, GP or GC or GTC. Okay? Now, tell me, what is the gross profit? 2,59,200. What is the marginal cost in gross contribution? 4,70,400. 470,400. And what is throughput costing contribution? Yeah, throughput contribution? 5,76,000. 5,76,000. 5,76,000. Everybody, can I proceed or not? No. From this, I should reduce what? Period cost. For all period costs, same or different? Different. You know, for absorption costing, only administration selling period cost. Kadaba. For marginal costing, what? Fixed manufacturing cost, administration selling is what? Period cost. For throughput costing, all are period cost except material. என்ன மறிடன்னாட்னா? So you should be writing respectively the period cost. கண்ணை பசே? Now, next is period cost. Unlined that. Period cost, unlined that. Period cost, unlined that. Can you start them? Now, first direct wages. First item is direct wages. Is direct wages period cost or not period cost? Not period cost. In absorption, it is a product cost, man. It is there inside that 45 itself. Gotta buy, it is not a period cost. Is direct wages period cost in marginal? No. Is it period cost in throughput? Yes. Right? 45,000. Period cost is 45,000. Variable overheads. Is VOH period cost in absorption? No. Is VOH period cost in marginal costing? No. In throughput costing? Yes. How much rupees? 65,000. Fixed and manufacturing overheads. FMOH. Fixed manufacturing overheads. Is fixed manufacturing overheads period cost in absorption? No. Is it period cost in marginal? Yes. 2,20,000. Under throughput? Yes. 2,20,000. Next, can I proceed? No. Next is what? Variable selling overheads. Look at the first step, the number has been multiplied already with you. Is variable selling overheads period cost and absorption? Yes. Tell me the number? 76,800. Under marginal? Yes. 76,800. Under throughput? Yes. 76,800. And period cost under all the three systems, 76,800. I hope everybody understanding it now. Next is what? Fixed selling overheads. Again, this period cost under all the three systems. Tell me what's the number? 1,18,000. Total period cost. Tell me absorption, what the total period cost? 194,800. Absorption 194,800. Marginal, what the total period cost? 414,800. 220 plus 76,800 plus 1,18,000. Throughput costing, can you add and tell me what the total period cost? 45 plus 65 plus 220 plus 76,800 plus 1,18,000. Give how much here? 5,24,800. Everybody, yes or no? Now, next is profit. The gross profit minus administration and selling or period cost gives you what are the profit? 64,400. Marginal costing, what is the profit? 55,600. Throughput, what is the profit? 51,200. Everybody, are you following or not? No. So, with this, we have completed the income statement under all the three systems. Those are clearly understood. Raise your hand. Now, all these areas are hit areas in the exam. Can any time be asked? Can I proceed or not? No. See, question is over. Just to have a clarity, some more discussion will be made before you wind it up. Can I proceed or not? No. See. Write down. Step 3 or step 4? Step 4. Write on step 4. Step 4. Reconciling profits. Step 4. Reconciling profits. Profits are same or different term? Different. So reconciling profit. Okay. Can you tell me why the profit is different? Due to stock valuation. Due to what? Stock valuation. Enna write on or no? So write on first. Write one by one. Throughput profit. First write throughput profit. Tell me what is the profit on throughput system? 51,200. To this, I add difference in what? Stock valuation. Difference in stock valuation. The difference should be between absorption and throughput, marginal throughput, marginal throughput. The next email system is what? Marginal. So difference in stock valuation
between marginal and throughput. Tell me, what is the marginal costing stock value? Tell me. How much? 9,000? 9,200. What is the throughput stock value? How much? 4,800. What is the difference in stock value? How much rupees? 4,400. Now, if I add, I get what here? Marginal costing profit. I have the marginal costing profit. What is the marginal costing profit? 55,600. Once again, add what? Difference in stock value. Difference in stock valuation. Between what and what? Absorption and margin. What is the absorption stock value? 18,000. Exactly, 18,000. What is the marginal costing? 9,200. Tell me the difference. 8,800. If I total, I get what? Absorption costing profit. I get absorption costing profit. What is the number? 64,400. That's how the three profits can be reconciled. Okay, if I adjust the stock values, difference of a marginal costing, I bring from throughput to marginal, adjust absorption costing, stock value difference, I bring it to what? Absorption costing. Everybody, are you following what I am saying? No. Last step. Step 4 or 5? 5. Step 5. Understanding expired and unexpired cost. Understanding expired and unexpired cost. What is an expired cost? Cost charged against the sales. What unexpired cost? Cost that goes to the next year. So, understanding expired and unexpired cost. Understanding expired and unexpired cost. Okay. Have the following four columns. Particulars. Absorption. Second is what system? Marginal. Third is throughput. Absorption, marginal, and then throughput. Absorption, marginal, throughput. Can I proceed? Now, total cost. Now only we calculate the first slide. Na? Tell me what is the total cost? What is the total cost here? 6,44,800. Is same in all the three systems or not? 6,44,800. 6,44,800. 6,44,800. From this total cost, what is unexpired stock? Okay. Minus unexpired cost. What is the stock value here? 18,000. It is how much rupees? 18,000. And this is how much? 9,200. And this is 4,800. Thus, point is so no. From the total cost, when you knock off unexpired cost, what you get is what? Expired cost. What you get is what? Expired cost. Tell me, what is expired cost? 6,26,800. This is how much here? 6,30,5,600. This is what? 6,40,000. This is the expired cost. This is what? Expired cost. Everybody, yes or no? No. Let's write other way around. Next is. Right here. Cost of goods sold or VCGS or TGS. That is the throughput cost or TCGS. Cost of goods sold or variable cost of goods sold or throughput cost of goods sold. Okay. We had in the income statement, can you remember and tell me or look at and tell me what's the number? 4,32,000. And to the extent of this, it will be expiring or not? 4,32,000. Next is what? 2,20,800. Third is what? 1,15,200. Apart from that, period cost expires fully or not? Now. Next, you have to add what? Period cost. Add period cost. In absorption, what is the period cost? 1,94,800. What is the marginal costing period cost? 4,14,800. What is throughput costing period cost? 5,24,800. 524,800. I hope you are all looking at the workbook and tell me the right numbers or not. None. What they get is what? Expired cost. Very simple. Product cost, expense section of the goods sold. Period cost, expense what? Fully. I wrote this. Can you tell me the number? What the total? 6,26,800. Next is what? 6,35,600. Next is what? 6,40,000. This is the expired cost under the three system. Yes or no? Since more cost expires, profit is what? Less. Less cost expires, profit is what? More. The expiry difference is due to the stock calculation, namely the fixed cost or the other conversion cost and the material cost. Everybody, are you following or not? No. With this, we completed the sum and what? The throughput costing. Please respond. Yes or no? Write down notes. Write down notes. Write down notes. Point number one. Product costs are those costs considered for stock valuation. And period cost ignored for stock valuation. Point number one, having the clarity here. Next, point number two. There are three types of costing systems. There are three types of costing systems. There are three types of costing systems. Branch it into three. What are three types of systems here? Absorption costing, marginal costing, throughput costing. Branch it into three. Absorption costing, marginal costing, throughput costing. Absorption costing, marginal costing, and throughput costing. Can I proceed or not? No. Absorption costing, put that down in my hand, right? Value stock at what cost? Full manufacturing cost. Value stock at full manufacturing cost, including unitized fixed cost. Value stock at full manufacturing cost, including unitized fixed cost. Including unitized fixed cost. Marginal costing, put that down again, right? Value stock at what? Variable manufacturing cost. Value stock at variable manufacturing cost. Throughput costing, right? Value stock at the raw material cost. Value stock at raw material cost. Tell me how to value finished goods or raw material cost. Raw material inside, finished goods. It will be the value of the stock. What is that? No. So don't say how to value finished goods or raw material cost. Ignore the wages spent for manufacturing of finished goods. Over expense. Value only at the metal inside the finished goods. Everybody yes or no? No. It was earlier discussed that absorption costing hides inefficiency by allowing fixed manufacturing overheads, FMOHs, by allowing fixed manufacturing overheads to go to next year through stocks. Bracket la, for more details,
See, marginal costing. Contact SSR. Okay. For more details, refer marginal costing. For more details, refer marginal costings. Can I put it or not? No. Please. Continue writing, same point. So for more days, refer what? Marginal costing, bracket close. Continue writing, same point. Fixed costs will anyhow be incurred. Fixed costs will anyhow be incurred whether or not the production take place. Fixed costs will anyhow be incurred whether or not the production takes place. Fixed costs will anyhow be incurred whether or not the production takes place. Whether or not the production takes place. Hence, should not go into stock valuation. Everybody following or not? No. That means marginal costing has done one work for us. What work done here? It just said what is bad about what? Charging fixed cost to the stock. Now we have to say what is bad about what? Charging wages and overheads to the stock in the next stage. Can I understand or not? No. Point number four. Throughput costing states that wages and overheads also throughput costing states that wages and variable overheads also should not enter stock value. Wages and variable overheads also should not enter stock value. What is tangibly, full stop and write, what is tangibly transferred through stock is only, raw materials. What is tangibly transferred through stock is only raw materials. We cannot transfer a labor time or a power consumption from one year to another. From one period to another. Everybody, yes or no? No. Point number five. Even if the finished goods is unsaleable, we can still scrap raw materials. We can still scrap raw materials, but not labor or variable overheads. Everybody, yes or no? No. Now we are given the reason why metal only should go into what? Stock valuation. More reason when I discuss theory of constraint measures, you'll be understanding it. Can I say it? Last point. Point number six. Contribution is equal to sales minus variable cost. Is the marginal costing na? Contribution is equal to what? Sales minus variable cost. In throughput costing, we use a term throughput contribution. We use a term throughput contribution. which is sales minus throughput contribution is what? Sales minus material cost of goods sold. Throughput contribution is sales minus material cost of goods sold. Sales minus material cost of goods sold. Sales minus material cost of goods sold. I don't reduce wages, I don't reduce what? Variable overhead. Sales minus material cost of goods sold. With this we completed to some extent the discussion about what? Throughput costing. Everybody following or not? No. See, in between a small sum is there is regarding marginal costing and absorption costing. Nothing there in the classroom to be discussed. I'll give the problem as what? Homework. Okay. It's a simple straightforward sum. You can solve. Any doubt, I'll clarify. Okay. Now, with this we have completed this area called as marginal versus absorption versus throughput. You know, question number 14 is marginal versus absorption. I think I need not do anything more because we discussed so much in what? Marginal absorption in a standard costing chapter first, in the break-even analysis later and also now. So we need not spend the time in unnecessarily doing a simple straightforward marginal versus absorption. I give that problem as homework. Okay, now. With this, one slot in this new chapter is over called as what? Throughput costing. Okay, now.